What if Benelux reunited today? Benelux is an acronym that stands for three so-called low countries in Western Europe, Belgium, Netherlands, and Luxembourg. All three countries used to be a part of a kingdom called the United Kingdom of the Netherlands from 1815 to 1839. Here's the map of the modern-day Benelux. All three countries are considered to be highly developed and have coexisted peacefully since the 1840s. The flag of the United Kingdom of the Netherlands is actually the same as the flag of Netherlands today. And so was the coat of arms of the House of Orange-Nassau, which has ruled the Low Countries since the 16th century. Just like today, the kingdom was divided into two main regions, the Dutch-speaking part in the north and the French-speaking part in the south. Eventually, the Southerners demanded independence in the Belgian Revolution of 1830-31. The successful revolution formed the new Kingdom of Belgium. Luxembourg, however, remained in a personal union with the Netherlands until 1890. The kingdom had a population of 3.5 million. Its capitals were Brussels and The Hague. Several languages were spoken, including Dutch, the sole official language, French, official in southern Wallonia, and minority languages like Frisian and Limburgish. In terms of religion, the kingdom was divided into two main faiths, Roman Catholicism in the south and the Dutch Reformed Church in the north. William I, the only monarch of the United Kingdom of the Netherlands, reigned as the constitutional monarch, with limited political power bestowed on him. So what if Benelux reunited today? What would it look like? How powerful would it be? Let's find out. The total area of the country of Benelux would be 75,149 square kilometers, making it the 117th largest country in the world. 56% of the area would be Dutch, 41% Belgian, and 3% Luxembourgish. The population would be around 29.5 million, placing it behind countries like Nepal but in front of Venezuela. Slight changes would be made in the country's linguistic environment. Both Dutch and French would be the official languages, with small German and Luxembourgish minorities. In terms of ethnicity, around 46% of the population would be Dutch, followed by 22% Flemish, 14% Walloon, and 1% Luxembourgish. Benelux's religion would look very different from before. More than 2 out of 5 people would consider themselves to have no religions at all. Around 36% of the population would be Catholics, outnumbering its old rival Protestants by more than thrice. There would also be 5% Muslims, mostly immigrants from Indonesia and the Middle East. The government of Benelux would remain the same as all three of its constituents, parliamentary constitutional monarchy. The Dutch royal house would most likely be the new ruling house of Benelux due to historical and economic reasons. Benelux would be an affluent country with a GDP, PPP, of $1.6 trillion. This would place it right behind Saudi Arabia and in front of Australia, which is 100 times greater than Benelux. The nominal GDP of Benelux would be even better in terms of rankings. With $1.5 trillion, Benelux would be the world's 14th largest economy behind Brazil, a country 114 times its size. GDP, PPP, per capita of Benelux would be $55,616, the 19th highest in the world just behind Germany. Nominal GDP per capita would be similar at $50,210, again, placing right behind Germany at 17th place. The Gini coefficient of Benelux would be 28.5, indicating a low level of wealth inequality despite having a high income. The HDI score would be 0.926, one of the best in the world. The Beneluxers would have a very high quality of life compared to other parts of the world. The currency of Benelux would remain as euro. It would also stay in the European Union as long as it still exists. The time zone would be at UTC plus 1 and UTC plus 2 in the summer. Most other European and African countries would be in the same time zone as Benelux to facilitate trade and business. There would be 66,000 active personnels in the Benelux military, the 56th largest in the world. The number of reserve personnels would be much less, 8,000. Now that we have seen how Benelux would look like if it ever were to be reunited, let's compare it with its neighbors, France, Germany, United Kingdom, Switzerland, and Austria. In terms of area, Benelux would be the second smallest country in the region. It would be 1/8 the size of France and less than a quarter of Germany. Population-wise, Benelux would be the fourth largest in the region. It would have a higher number of people than Austria and Switzerland combined, but still less than half of the big three. It would be one of the $4 trillion economies in the region in terms of GDP, PPP. The same goes for the nominal GDP. The GDP, PPP, per capita of Benelux would also be number 4, placing it in the mid-tier. Again, the same goes for the nominal GDP per capita. In terms of Gini coefficient, Benelux would have the healthiest income distribution in the region. United Kingdom would be the opposite of that. Its HDI would be ranked number 4 at a similar level with UK and Austria. The Benelux military would be the fourth largest in the region, moderately behind the big three, but far greater than Austria and Switzerland. Its reserve personnels, however, would be the smallest by far. Altogether, Benelux would have a fairly large economy, stable government, and a good number of population to sustain its growth. Not only that, it would have one of the world's highest quality of life and happiness, making it a wannabe place to live for many people around the world. So what do you think? Do you think Benelux will come into existence in the future? Why or why not? Explain it in the comment below. Thank you for watching.